Formally welcome all students and parents who have joined in for this particular session today. So today the session is titled as LST Achievers Meet. So we have students and parents who have done well, cracked CLAT 2021 examination, all the as a panelist over here, and then a lot of students and parents, I will say aspiring students. So students are going to write this exam in 2022 and 2023. So they are there, and the intent here is, can all of you share your insights? Can you share, what did you went through? What was a turmoil? What was a starting point of the journey? And how did it happen for, so that, the younger ones can learn from you? What was the thought when you started the preparation? How many mocks you took? What mistakes possibly, if the younger ones don't do, they will get benefited out of it. The role of GK, the role of quant, kitna reasoning pe kitna stress dena hai. So all those kind of issues. So let me first welcome Arif. So Arif, I have gone through the interviews which you have done with Shilpa ma'am, the study buddies session which you had with Manhar, and also so all of that. So we'll like you now, we'll start with Arif to share his insights. And if you can enlighten the group of Gurgaon. So all the students who are participating here are from Gurgaon. So what is going to be your insight? So what are those tips you like to share? How did you prepare for the exam? And what is going to be your advice to the future law aspirants? Let me confirm. So Arif has cracked a CLAT 2021. He has got a All India rank of 79 and a score of 103.75. Arif has also cracked ELIT. Okay, the rank is All India rank 61. Is that right, Arif?
Yeah, that's right, sir.
So can you please share your piece of advice with all the kids?
I think my first advice to everyone who comes to me, to ask for advice, my only advice to them is give mocks. That's how you get to know what you're lacking at, what you're good at, what you're bad at. So from mocks, you can do English, logical, quantitative, and, learn those concepts and realize where you're going wrong at, even legal to some extent. But GK is a completely different thing. So for GK, I will just say do daily GK, do aspiration month and daily. You have that resource. We all are privileged enough, we can attend such a good coaching center, right? So use that resource, that daily aspiration page that you have, read the Hindu paper news daily, analyze that and make notes, and then maybe move on to event daily notes. See, all of my friends group were able to crack both Bangalore and Delhi was because we had done GK so well. GK was never a problem for us by the end of the exam day. And I think for a lot of aspirants here, it's GK is a real issue up till the end, and they think in the last 1 week I'll do all of the GK of the past 6 and 7 months, and that really never applies. If you do GK every day, and by every day I mean I at least did GK for 3 hours every day, and that was a lot of GK, but that really paid off because all of us, and it shows because not just me but other 3 of my friends also cleared Bangalore and Delhi, and all of us are going to Bangalore, so that's a great feeling in itself. Other than that, yeah, just give mocks, keep analyzing it. Or if you don't get something, ask for help from your friends or the faculty here. That should be, ideal.
Yeah, I was asking, Arif, as you said that you used to give 3 hours to GK every day. That's really nice. Could you enlighten us? What did you do during those 3 hours so that the kids were preparing to understand kya karna hai?
Right. I had 2 sets of notes. One was daily notes and one was event notes. So for the daily notes, what I did was I went on the aspiration page daily and then I made notes from that. These were digital notes that I would, type out myself so I could have them in one place. So for every month, I had my own notes and then I read the Hindu newspaper daily. Then by the end of the day, there was this free, site that you could analyze the Hindu. So I would read the Hindu in the morning and then analyze it in the night and take the GK from there. So these were my daily notes. Apart from that, this took about 30-45 minutes. Apart from that, I spent around half an hour on my flashcard app. So I had this flashcard app named Anki. that I added all my GK to, and these were mostly event GK. So me and my friends, me and Manhar, used this app named Anki that we added all our data to, and we would revise that there, and it made it really structured. If you have watched my other interview with Manhar, in the end, we mentioned about this, you know, flashcard app that really helps. And then the last, I think there is one and a half hours left, that would be spent on the group where we would do new events every day. So we had a list from September to July, and all of us had to do one or two events every day and tell the other person these are the important points, and the other person would note it down. Either Rushil did it manually and we added it to Anki. So yeah, that was 3 hours.
Wonderful. That's very nice. Very nice. And I think doing it together, as you said, towards 1.5 hours each day, that is very important, because when you interact and when you discuss it, there are a lot of things that you remember for long.
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
So you remember those things for long other than just reading it on your own. Wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay. So I think the key learnings are take mocks. That's what I hear Arif saying. Take mocks and analyze a mock, which is very, very important, kids. So make sure that happens. Second thing is read newspaper. So reading is must, and GK is going to play a very, very important role here. So reading and reading newspaper, the Hindu, the app which he's talking about, making notes for GK. You know, I heard when, you know, so there is a interview of Arif along with his study buddy group, wherein one of his friends said, I made notes of three registers. Every register had 300 pages. So it was a notes of around 900 pages manually written GK notes, right? So that's the kind of effort which was put in to ensure GK is done in the right way. So that is it. So
if I can just add a few things that you said, as rightly so, you know, summarize my thing. Also for analyzing, sometimes, you know, we'd like to do it alone, which is fine as well. But I feel like if you do it with a friend, and I did it with Shruti, who has cleared IPM and CLAT, by the way, but like I did it with Shruti, so it really helped, because sometimes the doubts or the things that we got wrong was so obvious, but it didn't, you know, click in our mind because we have given the mock. So we had the same mindset that we went and analyzed the mock with. So, but if you do it with a friend, they instantly recognize that what mistake you are doing, and then it's so much easier. So you would just spend 2 hours, you know, analyzing a mock, and it would be fun to analyze each other's mocks and see where we are going wrong. And most of the times we had similar mistakes. So then we started recognizing patterns, and we started writing what did we learn from English or logical. And if I didn't know anything in quantitative, then I would write that formula down and make sure not to repeat that mistake again. But yeah.
Okay. Great. So, you know, so let's move to, you know, Avnish now. So Avnish, what is those tips you would like to share, you know, with the aspirants, you know?
I think
preparation strategy, what would be your advice to the kids?
Yeah, so I really commend what Arif did during his GK preparation. But honestly, I didn't do that much. I didn't even do a 1/10 of that in this attempt. And but I still had a decent score in GK. I'm not undervaluing the importance of GK. But my approach to GK was that you need to have a broad idea of a lot of areas of current relevance. It's not necessary to delve deep into everything. You should have a broad coverage of a lot of events, and that can be done through the News Canvas portal that is being offered by CL in collaboration with News Canvas. And you should be up to date with all of those events, daily updates and events analyzed. Those are the two subheads. And while attempting the GK section in the paper, you need to use a bit of your common sense also. You don't need to know everything with a 100% degree of certainty. There are some options that are really obvious, and you need to train yourself to identify those options. And just by looking at the passage, you shouldn't just skip the entire passage, because there were a lot of questions which could be solved with a bit of common sense. Like, for example, there was a question on human rights or something like that. And three of those answer choices were negative, or positive, I don't remember. And the fourth one was about dogmatism. And if you knew the meaning of what dogmatism is, you could have cracked the question without even knowing what that particular charter or act is. Similarly, there was one on Sheikh Mujibur's death when he died. And That, again, this is not a very logically sound way of answering it. It's just an intelligent guess. The answer was 15th August 1975. So I had eliminated two options because they were before the 1971 war. They were somewhere in the 1960s, and I was left with two options. And I thought to myself, why is the examiner asking me this question in the first place? So since this was on Independence Day, I assumed that this would be the answer, and I got it right. So this is the importance of common sense, even in GK, although there's a false notion that GK is all about memorization. It is about memorization, but it's not only about memorization. Then you need to identify what the level of the paper is in the beginning, let's say 5 or 10 minutes. I realized that this paper is definitely easier than CLAT 2020 because I had also appeared for CLAT 2020. And so I had realized that I have to attempt more questions, but I don't have to rush through the paper. Last year, I had in fact attempted more questions than I had attempted this year. I had attempted 142 last year, and I had attempted 133 this year, still got a positive, like a greater score this time. And this was because I read the paper in my own natural reading speed. And that is the most important thing for you to realize, that you have to maximize attempts, definitely. But you have to maximize those attempts according to your own natural and intrinsic reading speed. And reading speed can be improved throughout your preparation journey. It's not a one day or a 1 week thing. So for that, again, what Arib referred to was reading the newspaper, reading different kinds of articles, and exposing yourself to a varied degree of reading. Because the English section composes of various types of passages. Like even one came from Sherlock Holmes. You might say that reading non-fiction is very important for CLAT, which is true, but you should not ignore fiction as well. You should have the ability to understand even fiction. And so with respect to quant, there'll be a lot of questions that will be erroneous because I remember there were a lot of mistakes in the quantitative section, but you should not make that a factor for you to skip the entire question, because CLAT consortium as a body, unfortunately, does not like to accept its mistakes. And if you're able to solve those questions with the parameters given to you, you should go ahead with it. And later on, you should figure out it.
Avnish, you're coming from that experience, like, you know, when you got a CLAT 2020, when A34, right, where you had that pressure, a lot of pressure, what will happen. And then in CLAT 21, there was that maturity, that kind of perspective, a macro perspective, where, like, you know, you were much more settled and understood it's more about reading and understanding rather than just taking all that worries and all, right? Yeah. So the major difference between the 2 years. And I think even Faizan Mustafa has got something to this also, right? Where he has added very clearly, it has more to do about like common sense and reading habits and, you know, that kind of habits which normally help you. So it's not like taking a lot of pressure and all.
So last year, one major factor that was behind my, like, again, 839 is a respectable rank. I'm not saying it's not, but I could have done way better. One of the reasons behind me scoring that rank was that I had a lot of anxiety on the test day and even the week prior to that. I hadn't slept for the previous two nights. And that really takes a toll on your mental faculties, and it really affects your performance. So I think that you should realize that if you study the 1 week prior to the exam, there is no guarantee that you'll increase one mark or even two marks or anything. But if you don't sleep and if you stress about it, you're sure shot going to do worse than what you are, what your ability is. So you should have the ability to, like, calm yourself, and that can only come through like creating the test day environment. So you need to take the exam at between 2 and 4. I don't know what the timings will be next year, because that keeps changing. It was 3 to 5 earlier and now it's 2 to 4. So I think you need to fix your schedule like that. Like, this period on Sunday is for writing this test, and you should get your body within that cycle, and that will really help you reduce your anxiety and all of those external thoughts that really take a toll on your performance.
Okay, that's interesting. So moving on.
If I can add to what
Okay.
You're saying something. Yes, please.
I can add to what I absolutely agree to Avinash, what just Avinash said. If you are apprehensive on the day of the exam, there is no way you're going to score as much as your potential was, right? So before the exam, both me and my friends, we had been taking mocks on from 2 to 4 and wearing a mask in different rooms of our house. So on the exam day, and I've mentioned this before, you know, there was no uncertainty on the day, like what are we doing? We knew exactly what we were going to do, what our aim was, and how we are going to go about it. And secondly, about being apprehensive, on the day, I think all of us thought that we'll crack it. And even though we didn't know that we'll crack it, right? But you need to have that false, even I'll say overconfidence, that, you know, you are the smartest person on the world. And when you're walking in, every other aspirant doesn't know anything. And you, when you go there, you will surely crack it, because that confidence really helps in the exam. Because why not, right? If you can be overconfident on just the day of the exam, don't be overconfident in the preparation that this to aa jayega mujhe. But like just on the day of the exam, I'll say just be very confident in your abilities.
So how many mocks did you attempt, Arif?
So I thought I had attempted 35, 34, but then I saw a video was launched on mine. So it was apparently 35 mocks of CLAT and then like I think 10 more of ALIT, or like 5 or 10 more of ALIT.
And what about you, Avnish?
Sir, in my first attempt, I think I attempted about 45, 50 new pattern mocks, old pattern about 10. So, and in my second attempt, I had attempted about 15.
A key learning which Arif is sharing and Avinash is also sharing, adjusting your body clock. And we have seen this kind of a recommendation from a lot of students in the past, wherein every student is referring to, can you adjust your body clock to the schedule of the exam? And I have seen Jitin sir talking about it very, very often in the classroom also, because jab exam ka time hai, आपका दिमाग बिल्कुल अलर्ट होना चाहिए, फ्रेश होना चाहिए. वेदर द एग्जाम इज फॉर सीबीएसई, इट इज हैपनिंग इन द मॉर्निंग, और इफ इट इज क्लैट, इट इज हैपनिंग इन द आफ्टरनून. सो दैट्स अ वेरी वेरी वैलिड सजेशन. सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू नाउ तनिष. तनिष, यू नो, तनिष अग्रवाल. तनिष अग्रवाल हैज क्रैक्ड क्लैट 2021, गॉट अ ऑल इंडिया रैंक 1585, एंड ही हैज आल्सो क्रैक्ड एलिट. And his rank is All India rank 56. And that's why Tanish has been asking, ki who all are withdrawing? So he's very, very close. So there are few withdrawals from Delhi, and Tanish will be able to get into NLU Delhi. So that's it. So over to you, Tanish. I will request all faculty members to, you know, ask him relevant specific questions. Over to you, Tanish.
Thank you, sir. So I would say that most important thing to clear any law entrance exam is to have consistency in your preparation, because I realized that during the year, I realized that for everyone, the preparation strategy cannot be the same. Like someone could say that they prepare a subject for 3 hours like Arif did, and others could say that they did less. So I realized that everyone cannot have the same strategy. So it is important to mold your strategy according to yourself, know yourself. And for that, you need to give mocks and other topic tests, sectional tests, use the resources at hand. And for that, you will know that which strategy would be the best for you. Make your own strategy. And most other important thing is that to ensure that you are giving the most amount of mocks possible, because I do not think I gave enough mocks over the year. And that is why my final rank suffered in CLAT. But well, after that, it was like a wake-up call that I did not prepare well, so I have to do well in ALET. And I did some practice for that before. But over the year, it is important to also build up your base in all the subjects, because someone could not be good, if they realize they are not good in like memorizing GK, they could also strengthen their other subjects properly. Make sure you are doing well in other subjects, legal, English, reasoning. Keep reading articles and strengthen your reading speed and understanding capability. And in GK as well, you do not have to, if you also need to ensure that even your weaker section is not completely lagging behind. For that, if you have to recognize which is your weaker section and make sure to bring it to a level which is acceptable to yourself. Like if you think that in GK you are doing very badly in the start of the year, out of 35 you're scoring only like 15 or 20, make sure you're creating a cutoff for yourself that by the end of the year, I want to be able to score around this much, even if I am not doing very well. Like if I keep the cutoff at 25, I want to score 25 by the end of the year in GK. So I have to ensure that in other subjects I am doing well enough, so I cover up the rest of the marks. And that is why I think that I did not do well on the final day of CLAT, and I could not do the best, to my potential, and I scored very less. But I got 1500 rank and got a very low NLU. But in ALET, because my base was strong over the year, and I built up my capability in other subjects. So even if I did not do well in like subject like GK, I managed to clear ALET properly, and I got a rank of 56.
सर आप भी बताएंगे लाइक यू नो अभी भी आई एम श्योर यू विल जब तक वो फाइनल रैंकिंग नहीं आ जाता तब तक थोड़ा सा टेंशन आई कैन सी तानिश का जब तक रैंक नहीं आ जाता तब तक थोड़ा सा अदरवाइज इट्स ऑलमोस्ट डन सो व्हाट्स योर फीलिंग राइट नाउ
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू कांग्रेचुलेशंस टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स इंक्लूडिंग माय सन हु हैव मैनेज्ड टू क्लियर एलेट एंड अदर नेशनल लेवल एग्जाम्स I'm highly thankful to the entire team of the teachers, the entire team of CL who have put in their best to take out the best out of this student.
So that's very nice word, sir. And that is what I can understand since you are from legal background. So, you know, the kind of communication skills you possess being into law field are humongous. So all the students are watching this session. So, you know, so this is what law does to you. So it makes you a very strong, very powerful communicator, you know, that is what sir did, you know, he just touched heart of all the participants here in this particular, you know, webinar. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for those great words. Great. So let me now move on to Avisha. Okay. So Avisha, I will request Aritro sir and Jitin sir, you know, to, you know, share. Talk to Avisha and ask some relevant stuff related to preparation, mocks, and everything.
Hi, Avisha. A very good evening to you. Congratulations on doing so well. So you've been with us for a good long tenure. So, kaisi rahi journey? What were the ups and downs as others have shared? I would first want you to share whatever comes to your mind about your preparation that can help other students understand the journey of preparation.
Correct.
Good evening, everybody, and thank you. I would first like to say that all the faculty has been of a great help. I know I would text Shilpa ma'am and talk to her like 2 weeks before I gave CLAT that ma'am, I'm down on confidence. I don't think I can do it. And she told me only one thing, that I need to give my best and not to think about anything else. That even when we got the expected score, I texted her and I said, ma'am, I don't think I can make the cutoff. And she said, it's all right, wait for the result. And when I did get the result, it was more than what I had expected. So Shilpa ma'am and all the other faculty has been of a great help. So for me, I think one of the major challenges that I faced was my mentality throughout the preparation. I think for almost a month before the exam was when I started facing anxiety. I would have trouble falling asleep. I would lose my focus in the mocks. And so that's where the problem started happening. But I think the faculty again, also my teachers at school, my parents, my friends, they were people who were always believing in. They told me only one thing, that we know you can do it. So even when I was not believing myself, people around me gave me that faith that I can crack it and I can do it. So I think that was really important. And my parents itself, my dad told me one thing. The day before and even the day of the exam, he told me one thing. He said, I don't know how the exam goes. Whatever happens, happens. We have backups. What I want you to do is just go and give your best and not think about anything else. And that was my mentality during the exam, that what happens, happens. I can't change my answer once the OMR sheet is submitted. What goes in, goes in. And the moment I was done with one section or one passage, I would just reset my mind and I would be like, all right, next question, that's the focus. I won't think about what I've attempted. I won't think about what I'm going to attempt. My only focus was on the question at the hand. So I think that was one thing that I did during the exam that was really helpful to me. And I did attempt mocks throughout the year. There were periods when I would miss mock due to school. So then I would attempt like 2-3 mocks within a week in order to overcome that gap. But other than that, mocks were of great help. I was like constantly doing, I was analyzing wherever I couldn't identify my problems. I did reach out to the teachers. They helped me out identify my problems. So the thing is that one mistake that I do feel I made that could have actually helped me in increasing my rank was that because I started scoring low in GK towards the end, I put my complete focus on GK and I fell out in legal, which was one of my strongest sections. Then one section that I knew I couldn't do bad at, but because all my focus was constantly at GK, I fell short of scoring my marks that I could have scored in legal section. So I think if that's one advice that I have to give is that equally focus on all your sections, not only just focus on your weaknesses, but focus on your strengths as well, because sometimes what happens is that we are so focused on the weakness that sometimes we fall short of doing well in something that we could have scored very good at.
It was a nice journey, Avisha, like, you know, in the beginning where in the class you had all MUN type, all GK, sports was your favorite. You love to talk on all GK and all, and like kind of bindas and all. And later on in 12th, I saw you changing into that pressure wala student, taking a lot of pressure and all. So yes, that journey is like going to be very inspiring for the other students and all, right? So there was all highs and lows where you were like, you know, unnecessarily bothered. Remember even a session where we had where maths was not happening and, you know, your brother also joined in and what to be done about it and all, right? So just elaborate, like, how did you come up through all that?
So what I did was that, so my strategy was plain. So I knew how I was going to attempt the paper. I had sorted it out in my 11th grade as well when I started coaching. Hmm. For me, time wasn't the problem. So for me, the only problem was to consistently practice, which at times I did fail because of school and other homeworks and other events as well. But whenever I could, I would practice as much as I could. Maybe attempting sectional tests, maybe going through worksheets we had already gone through, and I would just be constantly practicing. Wherever, because maths was a major issue for me for a very long time, I also sought help from who used to be my maths tuition teacher as well. And she gave me 1 month of complete focus wherein she made sure that every day I was doing 2 to 3 hours of maths. And that was, I think, 1 month around October when I did 1 complete month of complete focus on maths. And after that, I would just practice the questions that ma'am was giving in the paper that we were getting in the classes or the questions that we were getting in the mocks. And in the last month, because I knew maths was one section, if I start doing badly in it, my confidence will completely shatter. So 1 month before the exam, I stopped with maths. I said, it's all right. I knew my target was to attempt two sets in the maths section. It was something that Shilpa ma'am had told me that this is, instead of attempting all the questions, I should just attempt the 8 to 10 questions that I knew I could score at. So I knew that was my aim. And I knew that my maths was at that level that I could attempt those questions. So next, my focus then shifted to rest of the sections. That I was constantly then doing well in them. There were times as well where my scores would fluctuate a lot and I would get really upset over it. I was like, no, I did better in this section last time. Why am I not scoring this much in this mock? But I think that's the whole part of learning and realizing how you're going to attempt the actual paper, because as the question says, it's a mock. It's not your final score. It's not going to define the actual rank that you get in the CLAT. So even if I was not scoring as much as I should scored in the mocks, I actually did better in the actual CLAT, and that's what actually at the end mattered. So I think right now, if I look back at it, I think it was really stupid of me to cry over my mock scores and feel stressed out that why am I not scoring so well in the mocks. So I think that's the thing, that mocks are for practice, that they're not your final score. So that's what the focus should be on.
And your father is not joining us because he has been so proud, and I think he played a very important role in, you know,
yes, ma'am,
getting your nerves all right, and like, you know, because you had that pressure. Hello, sir. So please, hello. Congratulations. You had played such an important role. Please elucidate. All our parents, all our students are watching. So you want to share your thoughts.
Right. Absolutely. Thank you so much. First of all, I think I did speak to you, Shilpa ma'am, also. It was really great to have you, especially on Avisha's side, because jab bhi isko problem hoti thi, bolti thi, acha main bas Shilpa ma'am ko ek text dal ke aati hu abhi. And I think you were always very approachable, so it was a great help from you and everybody at the CL faculty side also. Thoda sa issue actually hum parents ka bhi ho jata hai isme, because I think over a period of time we start expecting too much, and consciously or subconsciously we put pressure. Fortunately, I was not that kind of parent, but I think subconsciously मैंने भी कहीं ना कहीं इसके ऊपर वो थोड़ा सा pressure डाला है, you know, to score well. So I think one advice that I would have for everyone is that, you know, let these are 12th grade students or 11th grade students. They are far more sharper than we were in their age. So let them be on their own, unless of course you see a huge problem. They're very good at managing the resources that they have at hand. You know, they can balance their time. They can read from different sources. So for an example, I think the entire duration of Avisha's preparation in CL was online, not offline. And she's one person who loves to interact with people. इसको कमरे में बिठा दो तो ये वैसे पागल हो जाएगी. तो and of course we were not getting newspaper etc. also for a few months. So my advice would be that go to different sources. You have so many things available today. You get you know, phone apps like InShots where you get 16 words news clips. You can go to different newspaper. You can go through different sites to see what information is available. This session is absolutely awesome. I think it's a fantastic platform for everybody to understand what has helped everyone to achieve. But my one thing that I would say to all kids who are aspiring for next year or the year after is, you know, find your own mojo. Maybe something which has worked for Avisha or Arib, you know, may not work for you. Try different things. You still have time. Try different things. Maybe studying 2 hours in the morning or 2 hours at late night works for you, then so be it, you know. But take notes. That's absolutely important. I think Arib did a fantastic thing in taking notes, writing. The biology proves that there is a hand and mind coordination that body registers. So the more you write, your brain becomes aware of those things. So हम लोग जब पढ़े थे हमको बचपन में टीचर मास्टर्स लिख लिख के याद कराते थे. There was a specific reason for that because your mind actually becomes synchronous with your hand. So it's very important to keep making notes. It's very important to read from different sources. You don't have to write the or read the whole article. Just snippets and take short notes from it. Highlight, mark it. Understand whatever way. If one note on your laptop helps you, so be it. I would prefer pen and paper, but if that helps, so be it. You know, that is also good. So understand what works for you. Gather information from everywhere. All these students who have done well, and find what's your own mojo to get successful in next year or year after that.
So wonderful, sir. It's so nice to hear all that. And now the students will understand it is a team effort. From all this, one thing is very clear. It is not a student alone who can make it. It is huge because I remember you were applauding, like, you know, among 70, the number of students among which Avisha did that. So you were acknowledging that fact. So that was not the pressure you put it on. Also, that was really important for the student that they have that space where they can, like, you know, bank on. So great. Congrats. Absolutely nice to hear.
Thank you.
I would like to add one thing that the thing is that when we get into this exam mindset, because we are all coming from CBSE, so my mindset before every exam was like a month before everything gets off. The only thing my focus is on the exams that are coming up, and I knew that wasn't the same strategy I could go up into a competitive exam, because in CBSE we had a set defined syllabus, but we don't have that in a competitive exam. So I knew that my main focus was to keep myself calm mentally. So until and unless, like, I wasn't getting into full-fledged anxiety attacks, I was like keeping myself calm. I would like watch series. If possible, I would go on and play with my friends, or I would play on a PlayStation. Or even what we did was at night, we would always get together and we would try to play a game together. And then I think we always constantly had conversations. I think I used to get angry a lot when mama and bhaiya, everybody used to ask me about how am I doing at mocks, because when I did not used to do well, I used to be so frustrated as to why am I not doing well. But I think talking to them about that was something that really kept me sane at a time where there was so much going around me, from boards being cancelled to the whole second wave in March. So there was so much negativity, but between that, I think having these conversations really helped.
Great.
That was great. So this was Avisha Dhiman, a student of AMIT 46, scored an All India rank of 475 in CLAT 2021. Now the next student, you know, I have is Kriti, and Avisha and Kriti, you have to break a jinx. Both of you are from AMIT. Both of you wrote CLAT 2021. Both of you scored exactly same marks, 91 marks in CLAT. And your rank is right next to each other. Yes. So how does that happen? So your rank is 475 and her rank is 476. What has gone in? मतलब एक दूसरे का पेपर देखा है क्या?
पेपर सर एक टीचर के एंगल से बात कर रहे हैं कि यार सेम रूम में आगे पीछे तो नहीं बैठे थे.
So we were actually friends for last 5-6 years. So we've been part of the same school. We've been part of the same society. So we are actually really good friends. So I think even that, I think we were constantly in touch and we were talking about how we were scoring, how we were doing mentally. So I think that was also one thing that really helped. Although our scores, our ranks being just next to each other was something completely unexpected. But I think this was something that we had talked about, that if we would get the chance to go to the same college, both of us together, that's something that not only we would like, but our parents would prefer as well. So that's this was something we talked about, but it was really unexpected getting the ranks so close.
हाँ वही तो वो यू नो वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ डज दैट हैपन यू नो फ्रेंड्स. सो ऐसे तो मनहर एंड अरीब भी सेम स्कूल से हैं, सेम पे तैयारी करते थे, दे वर आल्सो स्टडी बडीज, बट रैंक डिफरेंस है. हाउ कैन यू गेट सेम स्कोर रैंक नेक्स्ट टू ईच अदर, यू नो, सो डिफिकल्ट, है ना. सो लेट मी आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन टू कृति एंड लेट्स सी, होपफुली अरित्रो सर विल नो सम इनसाइट्स इनटू इट. सो आई विल रिक्वेस्ट अरित्रो सर टू यू नो start asking questions to Kriti. Yeah,
good evening, everyone. Many, many congratulations from my side to all of you. And I'm not surprised at all with the list. I don't know if you guys remember, but long back, 2 years back, I remember I had told Shilpa ma'am that Kriti and Avisha, they are ones to watch out. They are going to do extremely well. And they have not disappointed me at all. Arib, I must say, first year, there wasn't so much expectation. 11th, I'll be very honest, if you don't mind, Arib. But 12th, he suddenly turned corner and he was really serious. And Tanish was from day one the live wire in my classes. He was the one who kept all the entire classes entertained. You know, whole class would be, you know, even if the lecture is boring by chance, but Tanish sabko entertained rakhta tha. That is one thing. So Kriti, would you like to share with us certain, you know, congratulations and how did you,
your entire journey, if you can tell us.
I remember you were panicking some time back, then I gave you lots of topics to read up.
Yes, Avisha panic karti hai beech beech mein. Kriti has this bouts of panicking and then all right, then panic, then all right.
And so, I remember usme Ramsar convention aur ye sab topics the, which I think you did very well.
Yes, sir. Right, so first of all, I'd like to thank the entire faculty, like all the teachers. They've been of great support, especially Shilpa ma'am and Arithu sir. Like GK has been like one of those subjects which I really enjoy studying, but at the same time, that was one subject where I always felt that I'm not doing up to my, like, not anybody else's expectations, but my own expectations. Like I was into you know, Model UN and debates and all those kinds of things, and GK was something I enjoyed, like reading newspapers much before I started preparing for CLAT, reading newspapers and magazines and all of that. That was one thing that I used to do. But even then, like, I always felt that I was not doing that well in GK, and that's where I used to, again and again, I used to text Arithro sir all the time that I'm getting this much score in my GK sections, and what all the topics should I be doing and everything. And then he would like talk to me about the topics, he'd send me list of the topics, and then he even made me talk to Kandarp sir once, who's the GK faculty for CLOE. So like getting different perspectives and all of that. So I think that is one thing that always helps, you know, getting different perspectives, because many a times that might be things that you might not be able to understand, that, you know, where you're going wrong or why you're not getting something right even after practicing or even after reading as much as you can. So that is where I think that you should, you know, talk to people.
people. You should talk to your faculty, talk to your parents, like different subject experts and all of that. So that's one thing that I have realized throughout my preparation, that I might not have the answer to all my questions at that point of time. So you need to be patient. Like when you're preparing, that's the like the basic difference between a CBSE or you know any board that you're preparing for and an entrance exam. That in an entrance exam, you require much more patience because in a CBSE exam and everything, you have a set, like you have set parameters, you have a set boundary within which you're supposed to perform. But in entrance exam, honestly, there are no boundaries. And especially this year, this is proved to be completely right, because, you know, like this is one reason why I felt that I would have done probably a bit better if I had known this. That, you know, believing that there's a particular cutoff for the entrances and all of those things, those are the kind of things that can actually land you in a lot of trouble. Like last year, the cutoff for, I remember the top three NLUs, and even for NLSIU Bangalore, that was 92 marks. Like the last person to get into NLU Bangalore was at 92 marks. And this year we have 91 marks and we're far behind that. And the same thing happened at ALIT as well, as the cutoffs that were, you know, there in place last year were not there this year. So this is one thing that you need to keep in mind, that even though, you know, having that perspective that, you know, how much attempts I should have and, you know, what would be the expected cutoff, but at the same time, you need to be able to, you know, gauge the level of the paper in the beginning. And if, let's say, you're not good at it, because let's face it, that not everybody is good at everything. Like, I accept this fact pretty much that I'm not good at, being able to understand the level of difficulty of the paper. Like, I am one person who goes in with a set mindset, a set strategy that this is okay, this is what I'm going to do, and this is how I'm going to go about my paper. I do this much in this section, I course do this section, then that section, and all of that. So I was not, like, you know, able to understand that what's the level of the paper and everything. And then that actually caused a lot of trouble, because after the paper, you know, slowly and gradually, when you look at all the analysis and everything, you start realizing that, oh, the level of the paper was easy. And the number of attempts that initially when I came out of the, you know, after giving my paper and everything, I was like pretty confident that, okay, I've done this much attempts. I was confident I was going to get, you know, above 90 and all. So that would be a good score. But then slowly and gradually you understand that, no, that is not a very... And the second and the most important thing that I'd say is that anxiety. And when I talk about anxiety here, especially in my case, like I got my CLAT result and it was quite, you know, not what I had expected. So I was like quite worried and everything and all of that started the anxiety. Like I'd say I was more anxious after getting my CLAT result than I was before appearing for CLAT. So that had a, you know, huge impact on my ALIT ka paper. So, you know, it's not about that you need to wait for that particular point where you realize that, okay, things are not working out with me. It's okay to, you know, accept the fact that, okay, I am being anxious. I need to talk to somebody. I need to talk to my teacher. I need to talk to my parents and everything. So just have that thing into, you know, have that thing clear in your head that, okay, I need to accept what my problems are. And only when I accept what my problems are, that I'll be able to overcome those problems and I'll be able to perform up to my potential.
That is like anxiety, how to pressure that, all that pressure and all. Kriti ke saath throughout this journey has been like, you know, as a psychologist, ki things are all right, nothing like that. So there is all those. Anyway, I can see Arif is joined with his mother, right? Ma'am, welcome. Ab hume na wo, you know, background story chahiye. Arif has been showing us like, main kitna padh raha hu and all. Wo jo 11th mein nahi padhta tha, all that jo issues tha, concern tha, hamara tension jo hota tha, we used to discuss. I want you to throw light on that.
You can hear me?
Yeah, absolutely.
So Arif was one jo, you know, he was doing multiple things. He had changed school in 11th. So he was in so many clubs and also he was a bit, I was worried, but I was never worried in the fact, I always had the belief that he'll do well. Somehow I always had that. And he was, you know, all over the places. So many clubs, so many activities. So he was bit worried about that, but I always knew that he knows how to, you know, focus, and he always had a game plan. So maybe even if he was not there doing the classes, he always knew ki I need to jack up the study wise and do what. And the good thing about him is that he used to read a lot since his childhood. So paper reading really helped him. I would say that he used, from six onward, he used to read in Indian Express and Hindu. That was his hallmark. And he was, because he was in the quiz club and so many other things, it all helped that. And in 12th, what I saw was that he was very clear, and mock really helped him. Because on good days, he used to feel very good. On bad days, he used to feel very sad. And we could see that. But as parents, what we did was celebrate his mocks also. You know, some days he got 120. We ordered some takeaway food and made it key. Okay, it's a good thing. You got it. And his friends also helped him. You know, they all pushed through that. There were phases when he was not very comfortable. And because of pandemic, anxiety was an issue. So we took him out and I said, speak to your counselor, speak to your mentors, speak to somebody whom you can identify with. So, you know, and there were people around him who always told him ki you'll get it. And I think his confidence was always there. So what I would say, as parents, we can only be in the background and, you know, make sure that you are there for the child and tell them ki it's okay. Even if you're anxious, it's not the end of the world. Like, he was very clear he wanted Bangalore, but I always told him it really doesn't matter if you are there, because we are in this field. So we know that. So it really doesn't matter so much. But kids these days are very focused. So somehow God has been kind and he pushed through that, and his friends pushed, and the CL mocks really helped him. He gave me the feedback that, you know, the CL mocks, and he analyzed it every day, 2 hours of it with his Shruti. So that helped him, and he used to write it in his diary. He never showed it to me. After he got through it, he showed me the mocks and all. And I let him be. I let him decide what he wants to do. I was only concerned that he should be happy and studying. So that was his game plan.
So basically, you gave him his space, which he, and you totally trusted that.
Wow. So I think one thing which I was listening to the conversation also with his study group, you know, so he used to attend less classes, but इसको मैम क्लासेस ना मनर पढ़ पढ़ के इसको पढ़ा देता था. तो ही यूज्ड टू स्टडी फ्रॉम मनर एंड यू नो सो समबडी एल्स. सो द लर्निंग इज, इफ यू आर नॉट स्टडीइंग, यू नीड टू फाइंड अ फ्रेंड हु इज स्टडीइंग एंड हु कैन टीच यू एट अ टाइम ऑफ योर कन्वीनियंस एंड एट योर पेस. सो दैट इज व्हाट.
या आई थिंक फ्रेंड्स हेल्प ईच अदर, एंड मनर वाज आफ्टर हिम, एंड देयर वर डेज व्हेन ही यूज्ड टू बी आफ्टर. सो दे हैड अ ब्यूटीफुल सिम्बायोटिक थिंग, यू नो, because they were classmate and they were very lucky that they had people, you know, 4-5 people from the same class trying to give class. That really helped them.
Okay, so I will now like to invite Shivku sir. Now, you know, Shivku sir, possibly, you know, all the achievers here and students who are attending the session. So he's the man behind all the mock tests. So we have been listening to so many conversations ki mock dena zaruri hai, analysis karna zaruri hai. But Shivku sir is the director academics for Career Launcher, and every piece of content which you are seeing either through study material or you're going through you know, the mock test, the analysis, it goes from his desk. So, you know, so the whole huge team of academic fraternity, you know, who are creating all of it is under Shivku sir. Shivku sir is the alumnus of IIT Mumbai, IIT Chennai and IIM Bangalore. And I will request Shivku sir to share the final piece of advice, on this particular platform. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thanks, Deepak. And first, let me congratulate all the kids who have made it through. And just a couple of, I'm sure you must be having enough people giving you advice now. So I'll just, you can add me on to that. Two things to keep in mind, and since I've been through two institutions and I've seen how people, after getting in there, good, real smart kids coming in, falling off, some of them going on to achieving greater heights. You know, the last 2 years for most of you has been all about CLAT, and or a lot about CLAT. I wouldn't say all about CLAT, a lot about CLAT, and you've been dreaming this dream of getting into a good law school. I wish to tell you that this is just the start of the journey. It's not the end of the journey. No, kabhi kabhi ki lagta hai acha hum pahunch gaye hain, theek hai, we have reached the place. But I think life, I mean, this is just the first spot, first destination. There are so many more destinations for you to reach. If you enjoy the process at the NLUs, I'm sure that you will get to work with a lot more interesting, you will visit a lot more interesting destinations. And it's going to be a lot more fun if you take it from that perspective ki aage bhi padhna hai, aage bhi mehnat karni hai, aage bhi, I mean, I'm not saying that just do only studies, but it's got to be fun. You got to enjoy what you're doing. So keep an eye on how you perform in the first couple of years, because that kind of sets the trend for how you're going to perform later on. So one, the first advice is, this is just the start of the next journey. Next leg of the journey is on, and don't feel complacent that you have reached your destination. The second is, I think, you know, the anxieties that you have come across as a part of the preparation for the exams, just before the exams. And these anxieties, these situations are not going to leave you, right? I mean, maybe 5 years down the line, you would be wondering, what should I do next? Should I get into a corporate law? Should I get into litigation? Or it could be many decision points. And at that point in time, there is always a selection. People are going to filter out other people. So this process is everlasting. So, I mean, I think as long as... So don't... You got to learn how to deal with yourself, right? And I think it's important to identify the anchors in your life. I mean, it could be your parents, it could be your friends, right? People who kind of pull you down and pull you up when you're, in your lows, and pull you down when you're flying too high, right? In the sense that keep you on the ground. So I think it's important to find those anchors. It could be friends, it could be parents. So this is something that you will always need. For the people, for the kids who are starting off your journey, right? And you are, or some of them are midway, you know, all the things that these achievers have told you, every bit of it is their story. And as one of the parents talked about, that you have to find your mojo, right? But experiences of others are definitely things to reflect on, because it always saves time. They say, hum log kehte hain ki wisdom comes only if you experience it. Char log kehne se nahi hota hai. You have to go through that experience to figure out, achha, this is what that person said, and it makes sense to me now. All these things will happen to you. And I think the learning is, each one has dealt with it in a different way. You must take these learnings from them and then move on. Otherwise, I mean, I'm sure everybody tells you, you must work hard, you must log, right? You don't get anything free. I mean, these are all things that happens. But look at someone who creates 900 page notes, right? To crack something. So I think those are things that you must say, that if we want to do it, I mean, you can always keep these anchors and these points as some references and say that, wo kar sakta hai, to main kyun nahi kar sakta. So I think there's a lot to learn. Mocks are something that is important, right? Don't focus on only things that you love and like, right? I mean, that's one thing that is... there's a problem with a lot of students, right? You tend to only pick up one area and then get in there, and you tend to do that more often. Remember, any competitive exam doesn't give you a choice of what you can prepare for, what is not. Only the guys who actually try to do well in all the areas, the weak areas, the strengths, right? They are the ones who will actually ultimately do very well in the final exam. And last but not the least, you know, ek student ka ek hobby hota hai, favorite hobby, material ikatta karna, theek hai, yahan se wahan se wahan se wahan se har jagah se, aur and that puts a tremendous amount of pressure. My suggestion, not because it is my suggestion, is pick the LST material, finish it. If you have finished it, then you look elsewhere, because what we do basically is, we always look at what is relevant. So whether it is the mock or whether it is the manthans or anything, I mean, whatever we think as is relevant for you is what we distill and give it to you, right? And that's essentially to save your time. Otherwise, I mean, any competitive exam like aptitude exam like CLAT, the syllabus is infinite, right? So that also leads me to the last point that I want to make. This is not CBSE exam. Yahan pe ab syllabus khatam hua aur aap shuru kar rahe hain, aap karna hai, ab shuru karenge mocks. This is no syllabus. The syllabus is already on. In fact, if somebody asks me for aptitude exam, your syllabus got over when you finished your class 10th. It's about English, it's about comprehension, reading comprehension, passages, basic math. I think this is something that is already done. So what you are going to do is take the test as you learn. I mean, as you take every test, you're going to learn something new about yourself, how you handle the pressure. And these are the things that take a little time and a little, feedback. You get a lot of feedback by taking mocks. Feedback from yourself, right? And that is what the mocks lead you to, helping your strategy on what to fill, what next, right? What are the things that you need to do? So you think of mocks as some kind of guiding light for you, right? They're throwing light on you, giving some kind of feedback to you, and in the same context also guiding you to do the next few steps. So that's all from me. All the best to each one of you, right? Guys who are preparing for the next year or year after that. And also to all those people who have just crossed the, it's not the final frontier. It's just the first frontier, I would say. You cross the first frontier. I'm sure that all of you will have a lot more things to do. We will hear more from you guys. Maybe some of you will become like the characters in Suits, right? If that's something that excites you. Or, I've known a lot of people after passing out of the law schools, getting into a variety of areas, corporate law, litigation. Somebody has gone into UN organizations. Somebody has gone on to study further in Oxford, Columbia, right? Harvard, right? I think there's that field is, that canvas is open for you. And I think you need to learn what, and I'm sure you will discover as you go on and learn how to paint this new canvas. Thank you so much. Thanks, Jatin and your team. I'm sure, guys, your teachers have put in a lot of effort. I think must give them a lot of credit for the kids' success too. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Shivku sir. I will now request Jatin sir to close the session with final closing remarks and the final input to students and parents. Over to you, Jatin sir.
Final inputs. So, Abhi, in the morning we had a session for Faridabad, and I may request Anish, Avisha, Avnish, Kriti, everybody to switch on the videos if you're comfortable. तो अभी शिवकू सर ने एक बात बोली थी मॉर्निंग सेशन में. मैं सोच रहा था अगर शिवकू सर से मिस हो गई तो मैं रिपीट जरूर करूंगा. शिवकू सर आपने बोला था, मेरे को बहुत अच्छी लगी वो लाइन और मैं इसलिए रिपीट करना चाहता हूँ, दैट फॉर्म इज टेम्पररी, क्लास इज परमानेंट. आई थिंक वो जो अभी आप लोगों ने जो बच्चों आप सब ने एग्जिबिट किया वो फॉर्म थी और क्लास में डेवलप करा है आपने उसे दो साल में, बट उसे कैरी ऑन करना, दैट इज व्हाट शिवकू सर वाज ट्राइंग टू टेल यू ऑल. कि यार देखो ऐसा है ना कि दो लोग एक ऑफिस में काम करते हैं, एक को लगता है कि वो बहुत मेहनत कर रहा है, दूसरा जो अच्छा परफॉर्म कर रहा होता है उसे लगता है मेरे लिए नॉर्मल है क्योंकि उसकी हैबिट बन चुकी होती है और उसने स्टाइल डेवलप कर दिया होता है. एज अरीब एंड अवनीश वर टॉकिंग अबाउट जीके, तो अवनी सेड कि बॉस मैंने अरीब जैसी मेहनत नहीं की, आई डिड 1/10 ऑफ दैट, बट आई डिड जीके लॉजिकली. एम आई राइट अवनीश? दैट इज व्हाट यू वर ट्राइंग टू से. व्हेयरएज अरीब वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट अ डिफरेंट स्टाइल ऑल टुगेदर. यू वर सेइंग मैंने नोट्स बनाए, मैंने बहुत ऐसे किया वैसे किया, एंड ही डिड. सो बोथ ऑफ देम हैड टू डिफरेंट स्टाइल्स ऑफ वर्किंग एंड बोथ स्टाइल्स वर्क. मेरा क्या अच्छा है वो मुझे डेवलप करना है और उस पर वर्क करना है. और जैसा सर ने कहा, शिवकू सर ने कहा, सब लोग बोल रहे हैं, फॉर द एस्पिरेंट्स हु आर गोइंग टू राइट क्लैट नेक्स्ट ईयर और नेक्स्ट टू नेक्स्ट ईयर, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि यार देखो पेपर में सब कुछ आना है और आपको सब कुछ करना है. अब आप कौन सा स्टाइल चूज करते हो, कैसे करते हो, वो आपको डिसाइड करना है, बट छोड़ कुछ नहीं सकते. And the ones who've been selected, Tanish, Abhisha, Avnish, and all of you mentioned very good points about what you developed during these years. Avnish ne bola, and we were talking about Arif, Avnish, ye log bol rahe the ki Tanish ne bhi shayad usko mention kiya tha ki yaar paper ka time jo hai us time pe set your body clock because as Avnish father sir I remember you said ki 200 or 2000 rank wale mein bahut difference nahi hai, it is just that day. तो वो फॉर्म वाली बात वहां आ गई, बट क्लास अपना मेंटेन करो अच्छे से ताकि अगली बार परफॉर्मेंस तो लाइफ में बहुत देनी है, अगली बार अच्छा परफॉर्म कर जाओगे, बट डेवलप दैट क्लास ऑफ योर्स एंड उसके लिए कुछ क्वालिटीज डेवलप करनी है एज यू वर टॉकिंग अबाउट एग्जाम देने के लिए मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कि उस टाइम पे अगर 2 to 4, 3 to 5 इवनिंग में किसी भी टाइम एग्जाम है प्लीज इंश्योर दैट एवरी डे यू स्टडी ड्यूरिंग दोज आवर्स सो दैट योर बॉडी इज मोस्ट एक्टिव. Out of those 24 hours, your body is most active during that time because ho sakta hai ki aap kitna bhi acha padhe hue hain, but agar aap exam wale din utna acha perform nahi kar paaye, you lose. So you're able to scale up your score just by being more efficient. Avisha mentioned about ki isko anxiety hoti thi bahut kai baar. So talk to people whom you trust and talk to somebody, otherwise wo itna load ho jata hai us anxiety ka that it affects your performance. And she also mentioned one thing, Avisha, you mentioned ki question karte samay jo question kar rahe ho us pe focus karo, aage piche ke questions ko bhul jao is samay. It is extremely important for an exam kyunki agar aapne piche question ek difficult chhod diya hai aur aap wo tension leke chal rahe ho, you will not be able to perform. So I think these are certain things which we should develop, and all those who've developed should carry it forward in their life and develop a class of their own, and you'll keep performing. Thank you so much. It was lovely having all of you and interacting with all of you. Thank you. Thank you, Shivku sir, for being with us. Thank you.